Hey guys, welcome in TBC, the big chess. I am Sekar for you. Today we will look what is queenside pawn majority and how to convert it into the win. But before this, we have to learn about queenside, kingside and the center on a board. Let's see in the diagram. E and D. It's a center. From F to H, it's a king side, and from c to a, it's a queen side. As you see, king and queen's position, you have to remember about center, king side and queen side. Now we will discuss about what is queen side pawn majority. Here is our another diagram. As you see in the diagram, both sides have 6 pawns, but white has 3 pawns on the queen side and black has only 2. C2, b2 and a2, 3, and b7 and a7 only 2 black has, so it's called the queenside pawn majority. For understanding the queenside pawn majority, we will discuss ex-world champion Botvinnik's idea. The game was played in 1934 versus Kamuk in Leningrad. Now come to the game. Botvinnik is white and Kamuk was black. e4 was played, c6, d4, d5, e into d5, c into d5, it's a Caro Kann exchange variation. c4, knight f6, knight c3, bishop g5, sorry, knight c6, bishop g5 and e6. We will not discuss about opening because it's an example of queenside pawn majority. c5. With c5, white is created a queenside pawn majority. As you see, a2, b2 and c5, and black has b7 and a7. Now follow the game. Bishop e7, bishop b5, castle, knight f3, knight e4, hitting the bishop with knight and with own bishop. So bishop into e7, knight into e7, rook c1. The idea behind rook c1, if you played like castle, so black take your knight c3, and after bc3, queen side pawn majority has gone. So with rook c1, if knight c3, then rook c3, the queen side pawn majority is still in white's hand. So black, after rook c1, black played knight g6, castle played by white, bishop d7, bishop d3. Don't exchange your bishop, your white bishop is guarding the king side and queen side. So white's bishop is good, black's bishop is only guarding the queen side, so you don't have to exchange your bishop. So Botvinnik does not exchange. So f5 was played. After f5, as you see, e5 square is now weak. White's knight can jump to e5 and then support c6 and later follow b4, b4, b5 and c6. If bc, then bc, the knight is here on e5, knight will also support, and then rook is here also. So white has set up his pieces according his majority. b4, you can not go to knight e5 because here knight g6 is guarding the e5 square, so white is not go to e5. So b4, white is continue with his plan idea, b5 and then c6, and if bc, then bc, and rook is here, and sometimes this knight will also support to c6. So now here is a question. Who is better, white or black? Who is better here? If I say white is better here, so anyone can ask why. Both sides has equal material, 2 rooks, 2 knights, 1 bishop, 1 queen and 7 pawns. So why white's position is better? White's position is better because of his queen side pawn majority. As you see, c5, b4 and a2, and black has a7 and b7. White has a direct plan too. White is creating a passed pawn with his queenside pawn majority, and it will cause some problems for black. So now come to the game. Bishop e8. Now we reach the next part of our discussion. How to exploit the advantage of queenside pawn majority. So let's see. g3. g3 is a good move, because g3 is stopping h4 and f4. Black is trying to attack your king, so white is stopping with g3. Rook c8, guarding the c file. Rook e1, natural developing move. The heading is the e6-2. If e4 knight will go anywhere, then white can take. If the knight goes to g5, then knight g5, queen g5, and rook e6. So after rook e1, black plays queen f6. So white plays h3. White take it calmly. Don't allow black to play some tactics, or don't wanna lose his any queenside pawn. So now white is supporting all his pawn with a3 to b4 and c5. All pawn is now connected to each other. Now here black plays knight e7. With knight e7, e5 square is vacated for f3 knight. As we studied, the why f5 is a weak move. Now knight goes to e5. Knight e5. Now this knight is supporting the c6 square. With b5 and c6, white can easily create a passed pawn. Queen h6 was played. Queen h6, f3. e4 knight looks good, but with f3, knight have to move. So knight f2. The knight f2, knight is hitting the queen. So if you take with king, so queen h2, king e3, then f4 check, gf4, queen f4, king f2, and then queen h2. The perpetual and game will be drawn soon. So after knight f2, white plays queen e2. Idea to capture the knight with queen. So black plays here knight h3 check, king g2, g5. Black is going with his plan, attacking the white's king. But here is a white's good move. Can you guess? Okay, now here is your hint. D6 square is weak. This knight can reach the d6 via b5. So here white plays knight b5, hitting the a7, heading d6. Here black has two options: either give his light square bishop, or either give d6. So bishop b5, bishop into b5, rook f6. Black is regrouping his pieces to attack white's king. Bishop d7, another good move after knight b5. With bishop b5, white is hitting the c8 rook, and also supports the queening square, where white pawn will be queen. If you see b5, c6, bc, then bc, and in a c file, white will create a passed pawn, and it will queening on the c8 square. And bishop on d7 also supports the c6, knight is also supporting the c6, rook is also supporting the c6, and later c8. So you see a huge pressure on c6. So here rook d8 played by black, b5. With the idea b5, c6 will follow, queen h5. The black's idea with queen h5 is later rook h6, knight f4 check, hitting the king, hitting the queen, and this queen will taking h2. So rook c6 played by white. Idea is normally creating a passed pawn with c6, bc, then bc. But here black plays rook h6. With rook h6, Black is threatening knight f4 check. As you see, knight f4 check, hitting the king, hitting the queen. So here white played king h1, guarding the h2. Now no check on knight f4 because king is now on h1. So here black resigns, but now we can see why black resigns here. If after king h1 black plays b into c6, then white plays b into c6, and after knight c8, so you can say it's a move force, or in this position it's a good move. The idea behind knight c8 is blocking the queening square, where the pawn will be queen, the knight is guarding the c8 square, or blocking or blocked by c8 square. So c7 hitting the rook. Idea, now pawn will take the rook and become queen, the rook f8, and knight c6, the final glory. The idea behind knight c6 is, if black plays anything like g4 or king f7, black plays anything, then if, let's see, if g4, then bishop c8, rook c8, knight e7 check, hitting the king, hitting the rook. Or if black plays king f7, so again bishop c8, rook c8, and then knight a7. So black has to resign forcefully. At the end, some important tips you have to remember with queens at pawn majority and always playing a chess game. Assess and analysis your opponent's counter chances. Thoroughly prepare your own plan. And the second, advance your pawns with proper support and make sure your opponent will not be able to stop your pawns. Like in the game, white has many opportunities of going wrong, and several occasions he has to find just right moves like g3, queen e2, knight e5, bishop d7, and king h1. If you replay the game, you will understand what I'm trying to say. Hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Bye bye.